On my travels around the globe, I've spent many nights on boats out on the ocean. Looking out across the water, I've occasionally been lucky enough to witness an incredible spectacle. A spooky underwater firework display known as bioluminescence. I've never thought of this as anything more than a bizarre marine phenomenon. But I've recently come across a mysterious incident which suggests something a lot more sinister. The story comes from the Ukrainian city of Sevastopol.
Ukraine's Secret Service raids the office of these unsuspecting marine biologists.
They break into the Institute of Biology of the Southern Seas, interrogate four of its scientists, and search their homes. What have these men got that the government is so eager to get its hands on? Perhaps the answer lies in the one thing that all four of these men have in common.
It just so happens that they were studying bioluminescence.
Bioluminescence is the light that many marine creatures produce to help them find prey, avoid predators, or communicate in the darkness. Why would the Secret Service be interested in the light of marine creatures? Is there more to this bizarre ocean spectacle than meets the eye? The answer could lie in a little-known event that allegedly took place during World War I. November 9th, 1918. The story goes that British Navy vessel HMS Privé is out at night in the Strait of Gibraltar. Many vessels are stationed in the strait in an effort to prevent German submarines leaving the Mediterranean. All of a sudden, there's an eerie shape glowing in the depths beneath the ship.
The glow revealed this unearthly shape moving through the water.
They identify it as the silhouette of one of the most dangerous submarines in the entire German fleet.
SMU-34 was one of the most successful, if not the most successful, submarines of all time. For 117 missions, she sunk 119 ships.
SMU-34 has eluded detection for years. But now, she's easy pickings.
The British naval records indicate that the submarine was identified and that it was sunk by depth charge.
Now, the story goes that the reason that they were able to finally see this submarine was because it went through a patch of bioluminescing organisms, which lights up the path of the submarine.
More specifically, experts believe that the organisms which betrayed SMU-34 were bioluminescent plankton, vast swarms of them.
There's millions and millions of phytoplankton in the ocean, and when they're disturbed, they light up.
Most plankton is invisible to the naked eye until something moves through the water and disturbs it.
If I was on a ship in the middle of the night and all of a sudden I see this light glowing, that's an indication to me that there's something large in the ocean.
The Navy happened to spot SMU-34 as it passed through a huge cloud of bioluminescent plankton. But it was pure fluke, a case of right place, right time. The question is, has anybody found a way to harness this unpredictable phenomenon and turn it into a reliable weapon of war?
Bioluminescence gave away the location of the submarine. So if you can imagine, if you could harness that technology, it would be one way to expose the locations of your enemy.
Military powers are interested in any technological advancement or military application that will give them an edge against their enemy.
There's evidence to suggest that after the sinking of SMU-34, bioluminescent plankton becomes a focus of naval engineers around the globe. And during the Cold War, the stakes are higher than ever before.
The Cold War was mostly fought under the water with nuclear submarines. And these nuclear submarines were getting more and more sophisticated and harder to track. So there was this idea of using bioluminescence to detect submarines that were undetectable any other way.
Rapid developments in satellite technology could make bioluminescence an extremely powerful tool.
I suspect, and again, this is only speculation on my part, that you could use satellites to detect bioluminescence.
Say you're looking down at the ocean and there's a massive bloom being disturbed, you could potentially see the bioluminescence from space.
There's little doubt that military powers on both sides of the Iron Curtain attempted to weaponize bioluminescence. But with what success? That's where the trail goes cold.
We do know that both sides have experimented with bioluminescence and have studied it, and we don't know how successful it's been. So in some ways, that's still a mystery.
If the military did figure out how to use bioluminescent plankton as means for detecting vessels, would we even know?
Military research is highly secretive. But new information from the US Ministry of Defense reveals that marine creatures are still very much on the radar.
DARPA are the American Defense Research Agency. They are the ones charged with inventing the future.
DARPA has recently launched an ambitious project. As well as using the light of marine animals to track submersibles, they're investigating the possibility of using sound.
One of the speculations is, as objects like a submarine move past animals, will make different sounds. So they may be talking to one another, saying, hey, there's something big that's just moved by.
Any significant changes in the sounds made by the animals can be picked up by high-tech hydrophones. Three creatures are being enlisted in this underwater surveillance mission. Goliath grouper, black sea bass, and snapping shrimp. They've been selected because they use sound to communicate with one another.
The military is experimenting with the use of fish and other organisms to detect the presence of submersibles. It sounds crazy, but it's true.
According to DARPA, this is a real program that they're working on right now.
Perhaps marine animals will soon be operating as underwater spies, if they're not already.
Just like a lot of closely guarded naval secrets, if it is being used as a surveillance technology, it will remain a secret.